from true life in God. I will never deprive you of my presence. Since you first visited me, my feet have tried to pursue a straight path, and I have been trying to follow your footprints ever since. By opening my ear a little, I have received your instructions and your melodious hymn of love, learning how to love. I have earnestly sought what was right, and my very core yearning to pursue your will, I locked my hands in you, clinging on you, determined not to let you go, you, whom my heart loves. Your school has taught us instruction, and your royal courts, wisdom. You have offered us lavishly wisdom. I give thanks to you, my Lord and King. Illustrious and majestic, the heavens and earth are yours with all its inhabitants as well. They are yours and all that is lavishly on it. In these last days you are bringing to your people a message of peace. You are fulfilling the scriptures that the world of the past will be gone. And while sitting on your throne you are saying, now I am making the whole of creation new. You are the Most High, the great King of the whole universe. Show us how frail we are in front of your majestic power. We are not even a speck of dust. Remind us that we are only a puff of wind that never lasts on earth forever. Bring us back to our senses. My daughter, I am as by your side. Write down my words. Let me remind you. The moment your spirit had acknowledged me as your Savior, which is the perfect virtue, you were born of me, and I, your God, since then delighted in you and you in me. I made it known to you that you were always mine. That day you had experienced and had acknowledged my power, I had allowed the scales of your eyes to drop briefly, making you conscious of my bounty and of how I held the entire universe in the palm of my hand. And that every existing thing created is within me. You dreaded when you felt my power, for in these few moments you understood that I am indeed the Godhead, who holds in the palm of my hand, life and death. And yet, at the same time, I am meek and tender and gentle of heart. I am all-merciful and my love to you all is unconditional. Happy the man who puts his trust in me. Lord, let everyone who lives desire one thing, to seek to live in your house and enjoy your sweetness, O God, and to enter your royal courts of instruction and become a true disciple of your love. I never cease to call everyone to pay tribute to me and worship me in my sacred courts, where instruction will be given to you, teaching you that all my works are good. Indeed, my works are great, past all reckoning, marvels beyond all counting. Even a single moment standing on the doorsteps of your royal courts is worth more than all what we obtain here on earth through our lifetime, let alone if we are invited within your royal courts. Yet, now I'll notice that in your voice, beloved, there is a tone of sorrow. I am listening. What is my Lord saying? Ah, Vassula, Vassula, today my people are going through the valley of death. The earth has lost its peace and is withering away from its apostasy. All that comes from the earth returns back to the earth. A deadly breath has slid over the face of the earth and upon its people. I had augmented callings through my messages given to you, so that you thirst looking for me, generation, and to seek earnestly my holy splendor, but you preferred to go on your own evil way. My father's wrath is reaching bursting point as earth withers away. The earth is tired of its people and the people too are tired of this earth that does not give them what they thought their due. The day is near when in despair they will be calling to the mountains, come, cover us. And to the hills, fall on us. But now the time is near, the time of my return, that is ever so imminent. Little do you know, generation, that soon, very soon, my light will be seen in the sky. Trembling with fear will grip those who disdain me. Cheers of joy will rise from all those who never stopped loving me. These will all take shelter in the shadow of my wings, for my saving help is loyal. The world, after that sign, will never be the same.